As of October 29th, 2023, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. Of these, the tallest volcano to currently be erupting can be found a mere 70 kilometers southeast of Mexico City. There, the summit of the 22-kilometer-wide Popocatépetl volcano towers to an impressive height of 5,393 meters or 17,694 feet. Popocatépetl has been near continuously erupting since 1994, largely producing Vulcanian and sometimes Strombolian explosions. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, the alert level was raised at an ash and often puffin-filled island volcano known as Bogoslof. Meanwhile, in Russia, Kamchatka's tallest volcano grew during the past month by slightly more than 100 feet in height. And, in what is this week's top story, the alert level was raised in response to an increasing amount of volcanic unrest at one of the most active volcanoes in the Philippines, causing a new exclusion zone to be implemented. This change occurred at the Bulusan volcano 7.5 kilometers north-northeast of the city of Erupting. Here is exactly what changed at the stratovolcano, which has produced about 1 in every 6 of the Philippines' volcanic eruptions since 1900. First, a progressively increasing rate of earthquakes has been occurring at Bulusan since October 14th, and over the next 11 days, 125 earthquakes occurred, including at shallow depths of 1 to 9 kilometers, during a time when normally only between 5 and 20 earthquakes would be expected during background levels of activity. Second, carbon dioxide emissions have notably increased at the volcano in recent months, particularly between June and August of 2023. Third, Bulusan's hot springs have notably increased in temperature since February of 2023, suggesting increasing volcanic activity at depth. But most importantly, two sections of Mount Bulusan are currently inflating, suggesting either the accumulation of magma or expanding amounts of gases at depth. These four criteria are what are expected to occur when Bulusan is specifically at an alert level of 1. During such a period, occasional and intermittent phreatic eruptions sometimes are generated, creating ash and occasionally even pyroclastic flows. As a result, on October 25th, 2023, Bulusan was officially raised from an alert level of 0 to an alert level of 1. This declaration created a 4-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions around Bulusan's summit, which cannot be entered, and also note that people should be vigilant if they do decide to enter a 2-kilometer extended danger zone on Bulusan's southeastern flank. These precautions seem fairly reasonable considering that every single one of Bulusan's eruptions in historical time have been completely phreatic. And phreatic eruptions caused by the heating of groundwater by deep magma, which can then flash to steam and explode, are notoriously difficult to predict. While Bulusan is statistically most likely to not produce an eruption during its current unrest, this volcano could now, in my opinion, erupt with little or no warning beforehand. Meanwhile, in Russia, the tallest point on the scenic and beautiful Kamchatka Peninsula is the towering Klyuchevskoy volcano. This stratovolcano is the single fastest-growing volcano on the entire planet, having grown from the ground height of 400 meters or 1,312 feet in 5000 BCE all the way to its modern height of 4,755 meters or 15,600 feet in just a little less than 7,000 years. Well, this stratovolcano, which has been erupting now for 4 months straight, appears to have in the past month reached a record new height as it gained another 33 meters or 108.3 feet in height. I say this because erupting lava and ash from its summit crater has seemingly filled much of this crater and created a new 110 meter wide and 33 meter tall small-sized cinder cone. And this cinder cone is still growing, with Strombolian eruptive activity occurring right now. And in Alaska, the alert level was raised at the Bogoslof volcano on October 24th due to a series of more than 120 earthquakes occurring in a nearly straight line on the southeastern flank of its submarine slope. Earthquake swarms of this size are incredibly rare at Bogoslof unless a magmatic intrusion is involved. Thus, magma is in my opinion likely intruding underneath a section of the Bogoslof volcano, but whether or not it will actually reach the surface and erupt is uncertain, as most magmatic intrusions fail and never reach the surface. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on October 28th of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.